I was sent back to Earth with a warning message to the church. My name is Sister Fanny. I became sick, and after a while, my condition grew worse. As a result of shortage of blood, the color of my blood changed. I stopped breathing, which means I died. At that moment, my journey to eternity began. Suddenly, I found myself standing before a broad and narrow way. At that place, I saw many people rushing through the Broadway, while only three people passed through the narrow way. In the next stage, I found myself standing before the judgment seat of God. I saw a crowd of angels worshiping God. They were saying, "You are worthy, you are worthy, you are worthy." Two angels from the crowd of angels confronted me with two books in their hands. One of the angels opened the book with inscription, "The Book of Life." With speed, he turned the pages of the book to the end, but my name was not found in the Book of Life. He opened the second book with inscription, "The Book of Death." He also turned the pages very fast and paused almost at the end of the book, looked at me and called me by my name, Fanny, and said, "You were given three gifts, evangelism, singing, and teaching. But you did not do well with these gifts. Instead, you devoted yourself to secular teaching because of material things. The value God places on Sunday service, weekly activities, evangelism, follow-up, and visitation." The angel then asked me, "Did you attend church service last Sunday before you became sick?" I answered, "Yes." He said, "You were recorded absent. The angels that takes record of attendance took record by 8 a.m. when service commences. You came 3 minutes after 8. So you were late. Lateness is equivalent to absence." Then he asked me, "Did you attend Bible study the last Monday before you became sick?" I said, "Yes." "But you were late," he said. "You were marked absent." He then asked me, "Did you attend the midweek service on Thursday?" I answered, "No." He then said that Sunday service, Bible study, and midweek service score 10% each. He said that my total score of attendance is 3 over 80%. He asked me again, "How often do you go for evangelism?" I said, "Very often." He then said, "What about follow-up and visitation?" I told him that I do them very often. He said, "Evangelism, visitation, and follow-up scores 100% each. You score 30% in evangelism, 40% in follow-up, and 50% in visitation. Your score is 120 over 300%. He asked me if I do pay tithes. I said yes. He said that we ought to pay tithe of all things, be it gift, gain, or salary. He went further to say that we ought to give more in offering. He then asked me, "As a teacher, if your student scores this marks, will you pass him or her?" I said no. He paused for a while and said, "What do you have to say about this?" By then, I was shivering because I knew that I was in trouble. I saw us reaching the acceptable standard, Daniel 5:27, "Tekel, thou art weighed in the balances and art found wanting." Hebrews 12:28, "Wherefore we receiving a kingdom which cannot be moved, let us have grace, whereby we may serve God acceptably with reverence and godly fear." The other angel, who had been silent, said with a loud voice, "You are unfaithful servant. Take her to hell." When I heard that voice, I was terrified. I wish I could disappear or escape, but there was nowhere to hide or escape. I wept bitterly before the angels, pleading for mercy. Unfortunately, their faces remained motionless. They were not moved by my tears and weeping. But as I continued crying and pleading for a second chance, the angel who was talking to me said, "Show her hell." I then saw many people crying bitterly in hell. 10 strokes of whip were given to me as a warning for being an unfaithful servant. The whip was so painful that I was shouting instead of crying. As I kept pleading for a second chance while weeping and shouting, the angel said to me, "Go back to the world and amend your ways." At that moment, I woke up shouting, "Fire! Fire! Fire!" The heat of hell fire was so terrible that I just couldn't understand the pain. Lessons to learn. Number 1. A Christian's neighbor is not supposed to go to hell. Matthew 22, verse 39. Number 2. The mission of every Christian is to make heaven and to take along as many people as possible. Don't fail God in this. John 15, verse 8. Number 3. Anything you prefer doing to serving God is your idol. Number 4. When people choose wrong priorities, they regret at last. Number 5. If you accept Jesus Christ, you accept life. Number 6. The life of a man does not consist on his possessions. Number 7. Christianity is the ability to represent Christ wherever you go. 8. Without soul winning, your Christianity is incomplete. 9. Be careful not to be an unfaithful servant. Number 10. What are you doing to get your neighbor saved? 11. The whole duty of a man is to fear God and obey his commandments. 12. Lateness to church is equal to absence. 13. To know about the top, ask from those coming from the top. Number 14. Ask God to judge your life and reveal any secret error to you, so that you can amend your ways before the judgment day or before you die. And number 15. Always ask for the forgiveness of sin on a daily basis and abstain from habitual sinning, salvation, restitution, and repentance. If you wish to escape the eternal fiery burning torments of hellfire and to make heaven, you must accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior today, because tomorrow is never promised. You must restitute and confess all your sins unto God, and also ensure you join a heaven-focused, Bible-believing, and practicing church for more spiritual growth. However, if you are a Christian and still indulges in various kinds of sins, such as envy, anger, unforgiveness, lying, hatred, malice, murmuring, gossiping, stealing, taking or giving of bribes, exams malpractice, fraud, smuggling and robbery, masturbation, fornication, adultery, prostitution, lusting after money, covetousness, abortion, lesbianism, homosexuality, kidnapping, rape, ritual killings, and assassination, you must confess and repent today. Or perhaps you are into drunkenness, alcoholism, fighting and quarreling, smoking, divorcee, polygamous marriage, occultism, consultation of native doctors for charms making, praying in the name of Mary or any saints or angels, bowing down to or honoring them. You must renounce all these abominations and plead for God's mercy. Or as a woman, you are still giving in to vile affection, changing the natural use of your body into that which is against nature. Therefore, indulging yourself in worldly fashions, dressing in transparent clothes, wearing of mini and tight skirts, or wearing of trousers. Exposing your breasts, laps to seduce men, painting of lips, fixing attachments, weave-ons, fashion jewelries and earrings, makeup, putting on extra eyelashes, piercing of noses, tattoos, nail fixing, and body bleaching, etc. The list goes on and on, bordering on worldliness. You must repent, dispose and burn them off, and ensure you maintain your natural beauty because the unrighteous shall not inherit the kingdom of God. Remember, your soul is precious and was costly purchased by the blood of Jesus Christ, and you can't afford to lose yours in hell for the next billions and trillions of years in eternity. With eternal sorrows, tears, anguish, and hopelessness of ever coming out due to the mere pleasure and fashion of this world that passeth away, which you can easily forsake now and make it to heaven. O heaven, a place of everlasting joy, without tears, sorrow, or pains, but rather filled with happiness in God's glory. Please, my beloved, don't miss heaven, and I pray to see you in that glorious city very soon. Amen.
If you would like to receive Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, why don't you pray with me? Bow your heads and pray with all your heart. Lord Jesus, I come to you today a sinner. I believe you died for me and you rose again. I ask that you come into my heart and give me a new heart of righteousness. Forgive me all my sins. I renounce Satan and every works of darkness in my life. And I receive the gift of eternal life today. Thank you, Jesus, for saving me. Amen.